morning, friends. Welcome to Sharekhan Pre-Market Roundup. Firstly, on the global markets, when we closed, most of the European markets were trading in green band, 1.5 to 2% across the board. Whereas the American index futures are showing a positive opening of 1.5% for Dow Jones. Finally, by the end of the day, the European markets settled around 1 to 1.5% across the board in green, but the American markets slipped from around 250 points higher opening to around 25 points on Dow Jones, and Nasdaq being negative by around 12 points. Coming to our markets, yesterday at one point of time we opened on a flattish note, and from there we corrected around 30-40 points on Nifty, but we regrouped very finally from those levels, and Nifty registered a gain of around 120 points till mid session, finally ending the session at around 85 points on the higher side. FIIs yesterday in index futures was buyer around 396 crore rupees, whereas FIIs in stock cash market was seller around 857 crore rupees. Domestic institutional investors were buyer around 1386 crore rupees in cash market yesterday. Coming to markets today, as of now, most of the Asian markets are trading in red around 2 to 2.5% across the board, bearing China, that is Shanghai, which is flat to positive as of now. Now let's have an update on derivatives.
Morning, friends. Early analysis on derivatives. In yesterday's trading session, taking positive cues from the international markets, our market also opened on a positive note, on a flattish to positive note to be precise. And thereon, we have seen, unlike last few trading sessions, market did in yesterday's trading session hold on to its positive breath, as market breath also remained positive throughout the day. And eventually, soon after the positive opening of the European markets, Nifty showed some kind of a short covering bounce and continued to make new intraday high, and went below the 7,000, went above the 7,400 levels and closed at 7438.10 with a gain of around 1%. Banking sector did show a significant amount of short covering in yesterday's trading session. On the open interest terms, Nifty have also seen some kind of an shedding of open interest, that is around 1.5% was reduced in open interest. On the absolute terms, 3 lakh shares were shedded in open interest, while cost of carry did decrease significantly. From 21 odd points, the Nifty premium did came down to 3 odd points in yesterday's trade, and hence in percentage terms in cost of carry it decreased from 10.5 odd percent to 2% currently. However, we'll consider majority of the unwinding which took place in yesterday's trade was on the due to the short covering which was observed by market participants. The put call ratio, we have seen in line with the market going down, going up, we have seen put call ratio also increasing by 1 basis point from 0.80 to 0.81, and volatility index did cool off after the resistance level which we did spoke about, that is around 20.20, 20.50 is a crucial resistance zone for the volatility index, and it did took resistance around that level, and we have seen a significant amount of cooling off in volatility index of around 8.5 odd percent from 20.22 to 18.43 odd levels. Now the options activity, 7500 call option did saw good amount of addition, that is around 12 odd percent in open interest, while 7600 call option I've seen some kind of a reduction in open interest of 2 odd percent. And despite market closing above 7400 odd levels, we have been seeing constant addition in 7400 strike price of around 8 odd percent in yesterday's trading session. While in put option, 7400 put option I've seen a minor addition of around 1 odd percent, and 7300 and 200 put option I've seen a reduction in open interest of around 5% and 3% respectively. Now the highest put base showing reduction despite market going above and closing in the positive territory is a negative sign for a market. And we did saw some kind of a 5% reduction in the 7300 put option, which is the highest in terms of open interest, with around 64 lakh shares in it. So market did gave us a negative sign in yesterday's trading session also, that the bounce was mainly to the short covering, and the trend have not been changed still, and still remains in the negative the trend still remains in the negative direction. So in today's trading session, of course, 7400 is the level to be watched out for, and we have been getting negative cues from the international markets, and it may we might see Nifty opening below 7400 odd levels, but however around 7300 odd levels where it's highest put base, we might see Nifty taking some kind of in support in today's trade. There are six securities in bank preview for today's trade, that is Bank of India, DLF, IDBI, India Siemens, Jain Irrigation and Unitech. FIIs have not been so much active in index futures, and they have not bought much of an index futures in yesterday's trading session despite market closing 1800 points on the higher side. Index futures, they were net buyers by 391 odd crores, while index options, they were net buyers by 794 crores. Stock futures, net buyers by 243 odd crores, and stock options, net sellers by 166 crores only. On the market level, our FIIs, we have sent at 7475, the lower range 7300, which is the highest put base, and higher range remains our VWAP level of 7475. X6 Nifty is trading negative, down by 75 odd points. Taking negative cues from the international markets, especially Asian markets, and it's quoting at 7362, indicating some kind of a negative opening followed by some pain can be seen in today's trading session. That's it from derivatives. Thank you.
Now let's have a look at some of trading ideas and some important news flow which came after the market yesterday. The first trading idea for today is being Reliance. Reliance came out with numbers yesterday. Numbers were good and ahead of the street expectation. Net profit came in at around 7290 crore rupees, which is at an 8-year high. A strong margin performance driven by both refining and petchem segments in a falling input cost environment has been the reason behind all this. Action to be taken here is long Reliance with a stop at 1022.8 for a target of 1074 and 1095. Reliance Power is the next idea. Reliance Power quarter 3 profit jumped to by around 38.27 crore rupees to 352 crore rupees. Long Reliance Power with a stop at 49.5 for a target of 52 and 53. Important news flow for the day. China has set Yuan reference rate at 6.5578 versus 6.5596. Assam company is looking to sell at Lutyens Lane Bungalow. The company is expected to get anywhere between 700 to 800 crore rupees from the sale of bungalow. Solar power tariff is at record low of 4.34 per unit as per the Power and Coal Ministry. Godrej Property has partnered Vihan for Thane housing project. Supreme Court has delayed government plan to sell Hindustan Zinc stake. Indian Bank board has approved raising rupees 1100 crore rupees via Basel 3 compliant Tier 2 bonds. ILFS Engineering to consider fundraising on Jan 23rd. Government has raised customs rate on specified medical devices to 7.5% versus 5% previously. Neverend Inmate has entered steel industry. IDFC Bank is looking to purchase RBS corporate banking portfolio. Government is considering new power tariff policy today. IMF retains FY16 India growth outlook at 7.3% versus world growth outlook of 3.4%. AI Engineering has started commercial production from the greenfield project and completed a brownfield expansion. Sugar output has increased by 7%. HCLTech quarter 2 profit also came in yesterday after markets. Quarter 2 profit grew by 11% to 1920 crore rupees. Triveni Turbine quarter 3 net profit up around 17% at 27.5 crore rupees versus 23.6 crore rupees. Net loss of BASF has widened further. BASF has reported a loss of 106.38 crore rupees as against net loss of only 39.59 crore rupees in the previous quarter. Net profit of Deep Industries has grown up by around 139% to 13.34 crore rupees versus 5.58 crore rupees. We have some important results today. UltraTech and Axis Bank are the two numbers to be expected today. UltraTech expected paid at 319 crore rupees, which is a degrowth of 12.4% YOY. Axis Bank numbers are 1940 crore rupees expected, a growth of only 2.1% YOY. Stocks with positive bias are BEL and Bank of India. Stocks with negative bias are CEAT. Stocks for investment are Infosys, IndusInd Bank, Britannia, Reliance Industries and Sun Pharma. That's all friends from our side. Thanks and have a nice trading session.